Hello friends. Welcome to my video. In this video, I show you step by step how to install FreeNAS on my computer. Before you begin, you need to ensure that you have everything you need. This includes the following. Setting up FreeNAS, a popular open source network attached storage solution, is not a difficult task. Here's how to get started and configure a working home server. In order to install FreeNAS on a free PC, you need to make sure the USB drive is bootable and has all the necessary files. Here's how you can get a USB drive ready to go. Download FreeNAS. Download Rufus, a program to create bootable USB drives. Insert your USB drive. Run Rufus, and select the USB. Click the disk image next to create a bootable disk using. Navigate to the downloaded FreeNAS ISO file. Click Start. The USB drive is now ready to be inserted into the FreeNAS PC to install the OS. Press the power button for your computer. During the initial startup screen, press delete or other key, depending on the company that created your version of BIOS. Move USB to be first in the boot sequence. Save the change and then exit the BIOS setup. The computer will restart using the new settings, booting from your USB drive. Select install/upgrade. Select the hard drive you want to install the FreeNAS operating system on. Enter a root password. Hit OK. Wait for the OS to install. Reboot the PC. Once FreeNAS has loaded, it's possible to select from various entries on the main menu, or detach the PC from a monitor and log in to the web interface from another PC on the same network. The FreeNAS machine should provide a URL, which is essentially the IP that has been assigned to that particular machine by the network. For example, we access our FreeNAS test machine using 10.11.32.41 in the web browser. Go to Storage, then select Pools and click Add. Select Create New Pool and click Create Pool. Enter a name for the pool in the name field. From the Available Disk section, select Disks to add to the pool. After selecting disks, click the right arrow to add them to the Data VDev section. In this video I have two identical hard drives, so I choose Mirror. After the desired layout is configured, click Create. Open the pool options by clicking the three dots on the right of the pool, then add data set. Click save when done. It will ask you to enable service for the SMB protocol. Go to accounts, then user. Click add. Enter the new user details including full name, username, password, primary group, and some others. Click save. Next, we'll create the Windows share. Go to sharing, and Windows shares. Click the folder icon, and browse to the path of the dataset you want to share. On the left side, leave root and will as the original owners of the dataset. To give another user ownership permissions, click add ACL item, then choose user for the who field, and your username for the user field. Accessing SMB share from Windows. Head on over to your Windows machine. Open up File Explorer, and type in /// followed by your FreeNAS IP address. You should be able to see your share here. Enter the login details of the account you created in the beginning. You should now be able to add, delete, and create files or folders. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Use these steps to set a static IP address on FreeNAS using the web interface. Clear the DHCP option. In the IPv4 address field, specify a static IP address that matches your network outside the DHCP scope. For example, 10.11.32.41.